Put this in the way. There we go. All right, cool. All right, guys. You have any? I know, man. We're almost. Spring break is like coming, and it looks like some people might have started that a little early. Let me see. What did it just put there? So any questions from homework stuff? You guys started the homework stuff? Chapter 2? No? No questions. You guys doing all right? How was your weekend? Was it okay?
I had a massive adventure.
You had an adventure?
My child climbed a tree and split her hand open.
Oh my god.
What the heck? Yeah, the branch tore through her
hand. Instead of helping, you went on an adventure.
Yes.
All right, I see. That was an interesting choice.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, is she okay?
She'll be okay, but you know. 11-year-old girls climbing trees, it's a good
thing. That's great.
Yeah,
as long as that doesn't put her off that. Excellent. Climbing a tree is an awesome activity. I actually did that. I climbed a tree. I didn't hurt myself, thank God. Not too bad, anyway. When you got little kids, you do stuff, and you're like, oh my God, can't remember doing this, and now I'm like, shit.
You care more about falling.
Yeah. All right. So I'm going to assume everybody at least survive the weekend, obviously. I don't have to assume that. You can see that. The rest of the people, I'm not sure about, but we'll find out. So no questions from homework stuff? No? All right, so let me do this. Before we get into word problems proper, let's do this first. This section 2-3 has got a couple of things in it, a couple of ideas. One of them, of course, is word problems. But another one is this. So now watch. People always, the minute I give somebody something with no numbers in it, everybody freaks the hell out. What is funny is, if I make the same exact equation over here and I just put numbers in, somehow it's so much, it's better. You can do it, Jeff. It doesn't matter if it comes out.
So it's W plus M over A.
Nope. Good try. No, you're really close. You're not that far away. You just forgot you're solving for A, not for X.
Oh.
So what would you do first over there on that equation? Now, what if I would have put a 7 there? Would that have changed anything? Mm-hmm. You would have added 7. What if I would have put a 28 there? You would have added 28. You guys, mm-hmm. Right? So what if I put a minus M there? Who cares? You're already going to do this first.
Add M.
Right? Why did you add 5 here first? So you get the thing with A in it by itself, right? I love it. So here, you want to get the thing with A in it by itself, so you're going to add M. And then the next thing that freaks people out is you feel like you're supposed to do something with that. But what the hell is W plus M?
W plus
M. Freaking W plus M, huh? Right? If you put WM, why is that wrong? That's multiplication. You said you're supposed to be adding this thing. They're like, cool. You guys understand? I mean, I understand. If you understand how to solve equations, you understand how to do this because this is still solving an equation. You get the thing with your variable in it alone first, and then the last thing you do.
So are we not done yet on the AX?
What's up? Of course, we're not done with this. Of course not.
Right.
Have we got A by itself?
No. Okay.
No. So over there, what would you do last?
Divide
by 6 and see, then you have to reduce because they're numbers. So letters are even better. Did I have to add these? No. So what's the last thing I do here to get A by itself?
Divide by X.
Divide by X. Now I've got A solved. A equals whatever the shit that is, right? I don't even have to do it. That's awesome. If they were numbers, I'd have to do that. So you really should love it when there's only letters, because then you don't actually have to add and divide and all this kind of stuff. Reduce. And you're all like, I ain't buying it, Jeff. All right, that's right. Cool. My statistics students, they are learning right now why this is an important skill, because I want to be able to write an equation I have in a better form for different situations. So you have to be able to do this, just manipulate letters. So what about this here? Which gotcha? I don't know, man. Oh yeah, we'll get there, don't worry.
You'll never see it anymore.
Yes, we will. Here we go. Not yet. let's see, what you got, Jeff? Sure, I like it. What's up? Alright, so what is the worst part of that equation? The division, good. And the beautiful thing, it is an equation, so I am allowed to kill fractions. If it's in an equation, because I'm allowed to multiply both sides of the equation by anything except zero, I can kill any fraction that I see. So what can I multiply both sides by?
C.
C. Kicks ass. So then those cancel. For some reason, some people have this still alive and distributing. It's like, that guy's dead. And over here, you could distribute if you want to. It doesn't really matter. Y minus 7x. Is that cool? And then, of course, one last step and we're done.
Oh, so you multiply the whole thing by C. So C.
Yeah, you got to multiply both sides by C. So if there are two terms on one side, they both pick up the C. You don't have to. You can't choose which one. I'm going to give it to you, and then the person next to you gives it to the other one, and everybody disagrees. That's not how math's supposed to work. You're supposed to get the same answer, at least at this level. It's one thing people don't like about math is that they're like, well, it's always just one way to do it. It's always just one answer. No, not in real math, but this is just... Anyway, so what's the last step I do here to get y by itself?
Plus 7x.
Yeah, why is y not by itself? Because something is being subtracted, so of course I have to add... I like it. Add 7x. So then you get y equals ca minus cb plus 7x. And you're done because there's no like terms. Kick ass.
So why don't you divide it?
Say again?
Why don't you divide it like
that? Is something multiplying the y? Yeah, so when do we divide when we're solving an equation? When something is multiplying the variable in one by itself. Because then to kill that, I would do the opposite. I would divide. Does that make sense? So right here, is anything multiplying my y? No. So division won't get y by itself. Something is subtracting from it, so I want to add that so it gets it by itself. It undoes that subtraction that some jerk did. And we're like, ah, shit, what did somebody do to this? I always think of it like you're trying to unbury the Y. The Y's been buried under all this shit. We're like, oh, get the C out of there. Oh, shit, add the 7X. Okay, then we got Y uncovered. Which might be weird, and I don't care. It's a kind of a neat way to look at it. Let me see, what else kind of weirdness before I... Oh, okay. That's not the major. Blah, 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 blah. Blah. Well, let's go look at this one. This gives people some trouble for some reason. Solve for h. My poor markers are dying. My markers are so weak. I can't get high off of them. I don't know why this gives people trouble, but it does. This is the easiest one we've done yet. the only operation here is multiplication, right? So how do I get my H by itself? I'm going to divide by the stuff I don't want, right? So if I divide by
pi
r squared. Right? If I divide by pi r squared, that'll cancel, that'll cancel. Do the same thing to the other side. So you get h equals v over pi r squared. Hopefully, like, pi r squared sounds familiar, right?
Mm-hmm.
That's the what?
It's like circumference, or the
area,
yes,
of a
circle.
I like it.
Yep.
Right? And this V stands for volume, so if I took a circle and then I stacked up a bunch of them so that there was a height to it, I get a cylinder. So the volume of a cylinder is H circles stacked up, so H times pi r squared H. That's the volume of a cylinder. Okay. All right, so cool. So don't just, you think about what's the operation that's happening to my poor little dude. Let me undo that, right? You solve it just like you solve anything. So now let's address Jackie's question. It was a good question.
I forgot what it said.
Oh, okay. We remember, don't worry.
Okay.
I'm
still reading.
Solve for P. Now, see, that's not going to do it. So if I said solve an equation and you got x equals 5x minus 1, is that done? Why is that not done? Because there's x's on both sides. Shit. So you can't subtract prt and say, there, I got p by itself. No, you didn't. There's two of them.
Combined. Yeah.
Are these like terms?
No.
Shit. All right, Jeff at this shit, man. What you do is, this P, let me freak you out a little bit. There's only one P up there.
That one.
No. There's
what?
One P, but it's been distributed to two things. So can you undistribute it? Yes. P times what is P?
One.
One. P times what is PRT?
PRT.
RT. Now how many P's? I see one P. And how do I get rid of this shit here? What's it doing to that stuff?
Multiplying.
So how do I get rid of the 1 plus RT? I divide by it. I divide by the stuff that's multiplying my poor little variable. So that's how you get rid of, that's how you solve for a letter. If there's multiples of them, you get them all on one side and you take it out. And then you divide by the stuff that's in there. Right? You don't want that stuff. I don't want this stuff, so I divide by it. So you get P equals A over 1 plus RT. Bam. I like it. And you all like, whatever the hell you say, man. So here, you guys try this. Two-step problems. It's a you get it or you don't moment. So how can I undistribute a W? Well, if there would have been W in front of something, what would it have been in front of?
A Okay.
Yeah, because W times 3 is 3W, right? What W times what is WDM? DM. So I just took a W out, basically, right? I undistributed the W.
Yes, you did.
And so could you? It's just distribution in reverse. Distribution is not that hard. So you just think to yourself, what would be here to make 3W? 3. And so forth. Equals 6A. And then how do you get rid of the stuff you don't want? I just want W by itself.
Divide.
Cool. Divide by W times this. So divide by this. So W is by itself. W equals 6A over 3 minus DM. Here's a good question. Can you cancel the, can you reduce the 6 and the 3?
No.
Hell no. Good.
Because it's talking about how many of the...
Well, because division doesn't cancel parts of a subtraction problem. That's why. If this was 3 times DM, hell yeah, I could do that because division is the opposite of multiplication, but division is not the opposite of subtraction. That's one of the most common threads of mistakes across all the courses I teach is people cancel things when they're not able to cancel them. So whenever you want to cancel, just take a second and make sure the operations are opposite. Okay. Operations are opposite? No.
Is it also because the 6 is talking about how many A's and the 3 D's?
No.
Is that...
Sorry. No! No. If it would have been...
No.
So that's the answer there.
Okay.
Now watch. I want you to see this. That I can do something with, believe it or not. That I can do something with because on the bottom I can take a 3 out. 3 times what is 3?
1.
1. 3 times what is 3 DM? DM. And then I can cancel these. Why? Because division cancels... multiplication. Okay, shit, then it would work beautifully. It's all about the operations. If you want to cancel something, you got to make sure are the operations involved the opposite. Okay, I like it. That goes across all the classes I teach, trust me. My God. Yeah, for this one, be careful. For this one, it would be 6 divided by 3. 2. Yeah. Right? That's a different problem than that, right? That one's done, and here's a different problem. Cool. So it would be 2a over 1 minus dm. I like it. Maybe. So is everybody cool with the fact you can't do this, even though your brain might go, oh, 6 and 3, beautiful. It's because division can't cancel part of a subtraction problem. Now, what did I do here? It started off as a subtraction problem, but then I rewrote it as a multiplication problem. Now division can cancel multiplication. Bam. No problem.
So that's the final step of it.
Okay. Yeah, this will be it. Yep. I like it. Okay, maybe. So can you reduce 3 over 8? Can you reduce that? Can you? No. Shit no, right? That's the correct answer is shit no. Right. Or hell no, or what the hell are you talking about, whatever. But isn't 8 3 plus 5? So what? Who cares? That doesn't mean you can cancel it all of a sudden. You couldn't do it here. Just because you rewrite 8 shouldn't mean you should be able to do it now, right? Because this is division and this is addition. But can you cancel 3 over 9?
Yes.
You can reduce that because 9 is 3 times 3. Now the division cancels that multiplication. Right? The same idea. So many, that one idea carries over so many things you do. When they're opposite operations, you can cancel. Right? Okay. Let's see. So that's that one section. So now let's get into what everybody's always like, when is it coming, Jeff? We want it. It's like Christmas. sorry. The word props. Please, Jeff. Please. Can I have some more word props? And word problems get a bum rap, and I don't blame the bum rap because a lot of word problems are so contrived and it's so sickening. But at the same time, until you learn enough math to handle a real life, true, full problem, you can't handle them. So we have to kind of contrive it a little bit to get you used to translating. That's really what word problems at this level are, is just getting used to translating from English to math. So don't get hung up in, Fred forgot how much money he put in these two accounts, but he sees that he's like, what the hell, who is this person? Right? Oh, put $15,000 or $20,000? I can't remember. I got so much money. Well, no. Who is this person? I cannot relate to this person. So. There we go. So the big thing with word problems, the way to make them easier, and we sort of seen this already. All right, so let's go slow here. So let's say that Bob has two more apple fritters. It's going to just say apples, but let's make them apple fritters. Then, close it. All right, so right there. Do we have any idea how much either of them have?
No.
But I can translate what I'm told into mathematical expressions. So what's the usefulness of that? Because then I can do shit with them. That's the only reason we do it, is because then I can set up an equation if I know something more about this. But right now, I'm not even going to tell you anything else except this. How could I write a mathematical expression? I got to write two of them because I have two players here, right? So if I had a triangle and it was about the perimeter, I'd have three players. They each need their own name, their own math name. So Bob and Jose, which one do I need to kind of know first? And then I can figure out the other one. I got to know Jose first because then Bob is two more than that, right? Now technically you could argue that it doesn't really matter, but to use the two more than directly from the way it's written, I want to call Jose something mathematical, and then Bob is going to be two more than that. So we normally use X. If you really wanted to, you just use J. Why the shit not, right? So if you don't like X everywhere, let's say Jose's number of apple fritters. Jose's number is it? What would you call that? Let's call it J.
J.
So then how many does Bob have? Bob's number of apple fritters.
J plus 2.
J plus 2. Okay. So this is the mathematical way to describe this situation. Right? And this, the math on its own, math can't tell you the answer directly unless I give it more information. I don't have enough information right now. But if Jose had 7, then Bob's got to have 9. So it tells you, if you only knew this one thing, then you know everything. And of course, they don't tell us that, do they? Shit. What they tell us is something like this. Together, they have, what do they have, Jeff? Let's say they have 38 fritters. Don't judge. They're not going to necessarily eat them all. You're sitting there thinking, oh my God, they're sitting at a table with only... Let's go. So now, what does... So this told me this. Now, what does this tell me I can do now?
You know how much they have
to. What can I do with these two things now? To follow what this says. Okay, equals 30, I agree with, but and I know you know what comes first, but you got to tell me. What equals 38? Good. This guy's plus this guy's. The big mistake I see is that the person didn't do this. They saw two more than, so then they write J plus 2 equals 38. Now, that's wrong, isn't it? Because that's saying that Bob by himself has freaking 38 fritters. Ain't true. Jose ain't sitting over there going, come on, Bob. No, Bob's got some freaking fritters too. Right? So together, I got to see Bob and I got to see Jose together. And now that you've got that set up, this should be the easy part, solving that equation that you set up. So this is why word problems, I understand they're hated, but it's actually the most important thing, because it shows you how math can translate a problem in English to help you solve it.
English.
So, I mean, how do you solve this?
Minus 2.
All right, minus 2. J plus J is 2J. 36. So J is 18. So that means what?
Bob has a healthy 18. No, 20.
Yeah, Bob's got 20. Jose's got 18 fritters. And Bob's got 20 fritters. And what's the way to check yourself? Well, 18 plus 20 is 38. Good. So you can always check to make sure that what you found does what it's supposed to do. So to be honest, the very first step in a word problem has not got a damn thing to do with math. What was the very first thing I did? I wrote Jose's number of fritters and Bob's number of fritters. That's got nothing to do with math.
Well, you're labeling your parameters so that when you figure it out, you know who gets what.
Yeah, I'm making sure I see how many things need math names. So then they can all show up in the equation like they're supposed to. Okay, maybe. So what about, let's see, let's do a slightly different one. Let's do this one. This is the one that freaks people out. I have, what you got? What do you have, Jeff? I don't know, man. Let's say 22 feet of fencing. Aw.
Real life stuff.
Sort of. I have 22 feet of fencing to create a fenced-in garden. I want to use all the fencing, all right? I love the creative students who are like, I'm only going to use this much because then the answer is easy. No, no, too bad. 22 feet of fencing to create a fenced-in garden. I need the length to be two more than twice. Width. Don't look at me like that. Again, if you start to realize this is not us showing you how to work everyday life. This isn't. I'm sorry. You're not going to get that. This is getting used to translating so that later, if you do go down a math path, you could do more complicated word problems, because it's the first level of stuff you got to be able to do real life problems, which is translating what you see into math. I need the length to be two more than twice the width. What are the dimensions? So we'll do this one together. Really, really good first place to start here. Anything that there's something visual that you could label, you draw the damn thing. My God. People that don't draw this picture are the ones that make the stupid mistakes, and I'll show you what the mistakes are. Now, somewhere I would say fenced-in rectangular garden, so you know what the shape I'm trying to make, right? And I'm talking about length and width. So I draw a little rectangle. Ooh, that's amazing, Jeff. Good job. Now, what are my players in this problem? What are the parts? What are the things that need names? What are the parts?
2W plus
2. Well, no, no, no. The parts are the length and the width. Mm-hmm. Okay, so the first step in a word problem, you can draw a picture, but the first step really is there's no math involved. You don't worry about the two more than twice at first. You just care about, okay, there's a width and there's a length. So which one of those is going to be just a single letter, just X or whatever letter we want to use? Why is the width going to be a single letter?
The other one is...
The length is two more than twice. It's got, so I got to know the width first because then I can do this stuff to it to figure out the length. So it's a very important step to figure out what's going to be just a single letter because that's what everything else builds off of. All right, so let's just give something that... So the width has got to be, what do you want to call it?
W.
W, okay. So then the length is going to be what? Two more than twice that. So what's twice that? And then two more than that.
Plus two. So 2W. That's what two more than twice that looks like, right?
I like it. Now, to be honest, I wish you didn't know any perimeter formulas, because what's the perimeter of any object? Add all the sides up, right? The only thing you really need it for is a circle, because it's a freaky one. There's no sides, really. It's just one continuous side. When do I... Okay, shit, right? But anything with corners, you just add up all the sides. There's no formulas required. Some of you guys know the formula for the perimeter of a rectangle. That's not horrible, but it kind of makes you feel like you're supposed to know more. No, you're not supposed to know any perimeter formulas, to be honest. You just add up all the freaking sides. Areas are the ones that are freaky-ass formulas you got to know. But let me label my picture. This is the width. This is the length. The biggest mistake I see is this. Well, the number one mistake I see... All right, here's the list of mistakes. Don't even write this stuff down. Or do if you want to, but make it really clear. These are mistakes. The number one mistake is the people that don't even do this or this. They just say, two more than twice. Okay, two more than twice. And then there's a number 22. Okay, let me solve. What the shit? You didn't make sure that you had all parts. You have no idea. So what's this really saying? Now we can see what this is really saying. What is this equation saying that the length gets all the fits? So here's what you make. Well, right? And then I have little things wandering in and eating all my stuff. Little mutants, whatever they are, right? You guys with me? Why am I putting a fence around this garden? Probably to keep stuff out so I actually can eat myself the stuff I'm trying to grow. You put all the fence on one side, the shit, what is that? And only the dumbest mutants will be like, oh, well. You know, he's like, you just go around, he's dumb. Okay, sorry. Stop having your own little story there, Jeff. All right. The next level of mistake I see is somebody does this, but then they write this. It's a little bit better, but it's still bad. Exactly. So you've done the width and a length. Still, you know, now it's got to be just a slightly smarter mutant to go around the corner here and go, oh, well, just keep going. Oh, yeah. Right? So this is why drawing the picture helps, because I haven't finished labeling the damn thing. Here's another length, another width. So what's the full perimeter formula going to be? It's going to be 2W plus 2. Plus W, plus 2W, plus 2, plus W, which I know some of you guys would just double that and double that, which is beautiful. So
you can just put
4W. So you get 4W plus 2. Totally. Well, yeah, it'll be 4W plus 4 plus 2W. Because that's what you get when you add these and add these. Yeah. I like it. Equals 22, because you want to use all the fencing for all four sides. I like it. So in your formula, you have to be able to see four sides somehow, right? I like it. And now should be the easy step. Go ahead and finish that out. Solve that. Well, good, Jeff. You made it work. Okay, I couldn't remember if I tried to make it work or not. Comes out to nice whole number sides, which is always good. So let me see. It shouldn't be too horrible. How many total W's we got here?
Six.
Six W's plus four is 22. Subtract four. Six W equals 16. Divide by six. W equals three. Three what?
3 feet.
Feet. Please don't make me be a dork and write down there three corn cobs, three shoelaces.
Me what?
I will do that. I will do it.
3 light years?
Damn. That's a big and that is a dorky thing to do, but I mean, units are key. I gotta know.
And then what's the other piece that I got to answer? Length. So if you just do this, you're not quite right. The length is twice 3 plus 2. So the length is 8 feet. Now how do you check that?
3 plus 8 plus 3 plus 8 is 11 plus 11 is 22. Thank God. Right? Does what it's supposed to do. You can actually check these at the end. They have to make physical sense.
So the answer is 3 feet.
The answer is 3 by 8.
Right?
So the dimensions, so that implies that I need the width and the length. Right? If I'm going to come out there and build your garden, you say make it 3 feet wide, I'm like, I got total rein on how long I make this sucker. Right? No, 3 by 8. So here, let me give you this. One side has got two worked out examples, different from what we've done. And the other side is what I want you guys to work on. Together would be the greatest thing in the world. Right? Unless you just want to be, you know, antisocial. Sorry.
The dimensions is 8 by 3 feet.
Dimensions just mean length, width, height, if it's three dimensional.
Oh.
It's all colorful and stuff. That's big for me.